before you tonight. We're hungry and we're thirsty for more of you. God, no one made us come here tonight. No one's taking attendance. No one's taking note of the fact that we are spending the next 2 hours here in this room. But we pray, God, that you would be the one to fix your eyes on us tonight. And that would be what makes it worthwhile. That your eyes would be on us. Our eyes would be on you, that tonight we would encounter the living God in this place of worship and of prayer. Draw our hearts to you tonight, God. If there's any distractions, if there's anything that's keeping us from meeting you face to face, God, would you do away with it? Would you cast it out? That we would meet you face to face, Lord God. Sanctuary. Make this your holy of holies. Thank you.
Thank you. There is none like you. There is no one who loves us like you do. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for your everlasting, unshakable, unchanging love for us, God. Lord, help us just to grow in confidence of that love, of your love for us tonight. Holy Spirit, we thank you that you are here, and we just ask you to awaken us, awaken our hearts, awaken our spirits tonight as we come into your presence, God, as we cry out for the nations, God. Stir us, Lord, stir us tonight. We want more of you, God. Thank you. Just thank you. Thank you so much. We love you, Lord. Amen. For the next 10 minutes, we'll go into a time of meditation over the scriptures. So please ask that you would actually not open your Bibles or, you know, pray aloud. But as I read through the word in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 8, I encourage you just to listen, just to receive and allow the word of God just to wash over you. So please close your eyes and posture yourselves to just receive these words into your heart. Isaiah chapter 49, verse 8. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor, I have answered you. In a day of salvation, I have helped you. I will keep you. Give you as a covenant to the people. Thus says the Lord. Thus says the Lord. In a time of favor, I have answered you. I, the Lord, have answered you. Thus says the Lord, in a day of salvation, I have helped you. I have helped you. Thank you. I will give you as a covenant to the people. Thus says the Lord. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor, I have answered you. In a day of salvation, I have helped you. just thank you. We thank you that you are always with us. You are always by our side, whether in times of favor or in times of despair. And in the day of salvation, God, yeah, we just thank you, God, that you are always present and we can always cry out to you. We can always talk to you, God. We can always reach out to you and trust you. Yes, Lord, help us to be a people that just hold on to you, a people that just seek your face beyond anything else in this world. Thank you, God. Thank you that you are always there for us. Now we're going to go into a time of singing through the Word of God. So for the next 45 minutes or so of tonight's session, we'll be ministering to the Lord by singing through His Word. So feel free in this time, you know, to open your Bibles, to read through the scriptures that we go through, to meditate, to even reflect and write in your journals. Just let the Word take you on a journey in this next part of tonight's session. So we'll be reading and singing through Isaiah chapter 49, verses 8 to 12. Isaiah chapter 49, verse 8 to 12. This is Isaiah chapter 49, verse 8. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor I have answered you. In a day of salvation I have helped you. Lord, we declare that you are the God who answers us. You do not ignore us. You do not remain silent, but you hear every thought and prayer that we have. Help us never to doubt your presence and to always call out to you and just ask of you. In times of favor, may we never forget you. May we never stop relying on you. Thank you, Lord, that you are the God who answers us.
If we have forgotten how to ask from you,
I come to you.
Fail, God.
Trust in you. I will learn to trust in you. In every moment of doubt, in every
Isaiah chapter 49, verses 8 and 9. I will keep you and give you as a covenant to the people, to establish the land, to apportion the desolate heritages, saying to the prisoners, come out, and to those who are in darkness, appear. We are made for something more. Lord, you have kept us in your grace and love so that we may bring freedom to the prisoners and light to those who are in darkness. All that we have received from you is so that we can be your hands and feet in this world, so that we can be the salt and light of this world, so that others can experience the freedom and joy that we do. Lord, never let us forget why we are chosen. Help us to see beyond ourselves and to see the world through your eyes and with your heart. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. are more than enough.
They shall feed along the ways. On all bare heights shall be their pasture. They shall not hunger or thirst, neither scorching wind nor sun shall strike them. For he who has pity on them will lead them, and by springs of water will guide them. Lord, we trust in you as our provider. We declare that those whom you lead will never hunger or thirst. Why do we fear? Why are we anxious, Lord? Spiritually, you are our satisfaction. You give us the word, the bread of life, and you pour out your living water upon us to quench our deepest thirst. And materially, Lord, we believe that your provision is all that we need. So Holy Spirit, take away our fears and worries regarding our material lack and increase our faith in your provision. You are Jehovah Jireh, God our provider.
Here.
believe it, God.
You said than enough, God.
Father, we just thank you that you are always near us, that you always hear us, that you always answer us, God. We thank you, God, that you have called us. You send us out to be a blessing to the nations, God, to bring freedom to those in the darkness. And we thank you, God, that we have nothing to fear, that you are our provider. We can drop everything and just follow you. And there is nothing to fear. There is nothing that we will lack because we have you. You satisfy us, God. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. to now, we'll be moving into a time of intercession. And we're going to continue from last week's prayer topic. We're going to be praying into the issue of sex trade and human trafficking, in particular, child prostitution and trafficking. This is an issue that has come to the forefront due to the 2014 FIFA World Cup being held in Brazil currently. But it also came up during the NFL Super Bowl earlier this year. So tonight specifically, we're going to be praying for the church. The church, you know, that is across the world, and also the Brazilian church specifically, you know, as it responds to the situation, as it begins to mobilize to fight against this evil. We're also going to be praying for the government of Brazil to change laws that contribute to child prostitution. And finally, we're going to pray for the light of Jesus to shine into the darkness of this situation. Currently, there are roughly 500,000 child sex workers in Brazil, as young as 10 years of age. And each time, they may receive from 50 cents to $4. Every year, about 40,000 children are taken, kidnapped. 34,000 are found by the police, and 6,000 remain lost to the industry. Now, if you're finding it difficult to really engage with this topic, because it's difficult to relate to victims of sex trafficking, as I was praying into this matter, you know, the Holy Spirit said, don't worry about trying to sympathize or empathize. You know, how can you? Instead, focus on the heart of God. Everything we've been reading and singing through the Word today, tonight, you know, that's the heart of God that we want to pray into this situation. If you know God's Word, you know His heart, and you can declare that into this issue to change things, to shift the nations. So let's pray for the church. Father God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, that you have begun to move the church around the world, and that you have begun to unify them together in the fight against the sex trade. And Lord, we just pray as they are one, as they show that unity, God, that the world will see the power of your gospel, God, the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord Father. And Lord, we pray specifically for a sister, a Catholic sister called Gabriella Batani, who is an organizer of Talitha Kum, which is a coalition from all across the world of people fighting, who are fighting the sex trade, the child prostitution in Brazil, God. Lord, we lift them up to you right now. Let's pray for them.
Oh,
invite you after I lead with the prayer topic. Please join in praying for Brazil with me. Father God, we just lift up the Brazilian church to you, Lord, right now. Lord, you have said in your word that you are calling your people to arise and shine, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord rises upon you. Lord, we just pray that you just wake up the Brazilian church right now to stand up, Lord Father, to be your light in Brazil in the fight against child prostitution and sex trafficking, God. Lord, you have called them, God. You have chosen them. You have chosen them to bring freedom to the prisoners, Lord Father. You have chosen them. We lift them up, God. And we lift up our brother Ronald Neptune, Lord Father, who is working tirelessly, Lord Father, in Brazil to bring freedom to these children, God. Lord, we lift up our brothers and sisters in the Brazilian church to you right now. Let's pray for them right now, church. Church to be forerunners in the fight against global prostitution. Forerunners in the fight against global prostitution. Thank you. Lord, we lift up the government of Brazil to you right now, God. We declare, Lord, that your justice, your law, your commands are the light of the world, God. And we just pray against all corruption, God, all police violence and rape, God, all unjust laws that make these children so vulnerable to the sex industry, God, and to human trafficking, Lord. Lord, we just declare, God, we declare, Holy Spirit, move in Brazil and the governments of Brazil, raise up Christian leaders, God, that the laws will change to reflect your word, to reflect your commands, God. Yes, God, we ask, Lord, that you change, bring change in Brazil, God. Change the laws. Raise up godly leaders in the government of Brazil. Let's cry out to the God right now. Thank you. of God's anointing on the documentary, God, that's been released before the world comes. Pray for God's anointing on the documentary, that it may bring awareness, shine light into the darkness. Darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Lord Jesus, you are the light, you are the hope of the world. Into the darkest of situations, God, you can shine and bring hope and vision and restoration, God. Lord, we just lift up the helpless, the victims, the children, God, of sex trafficking, especially in Brazil, Lord Father. Lord Jesus, may you just bring hope into their hearts, God. Bring light into their situation, Lord Father. May you comfort them. May you comfort them, God, as they cry out to you, God. Lord, you are the answer. You are their answer. Lord, you are using your church to be your hands and feet to reach out to them, God. And Father, we even pray for the pimps and the traffickers, God, because they are crying out to you as well, Lord Father. They are in the darkness. Their lives are so empty and lost because they do not know you, God. Lord, answer them, God, in the day of their salvation, God. Will you help them, Lord? Lord, shine your light. Shine your light. Let's pray. Let's pray for the light of Jesus to be shined into this darkness, church.
Oh,
Yes, Lord. Jesus, nothing but your blood can bring redemption. Nothing but your blood can wash away the shame, the guilt, the sin. Nothing but your blood can change this world, God. Can bring everlasting change in this world. Yes. Lord, we just ask for your blood just to cover Brazil. Your blood to empower the church, your church in Brazil. Your power to bring your blood to bring freedom to the children, to the victims of prostitution. And your blood to bring redemption and forgiveness to the pimps and traffickers, Lord. You love them so much. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for your love. That you are always there for us. Whoever we are, whatever we've done, you are always right there beside us. Covers us. So we just thank you, Lord. We thank you for tonight. And we believe your word changes the world. So we just thank you, God. We just pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
In every hopeless situation, we know that we have one found. We know that we have one salvation. We know that there is one name that can defeat all sin, can defeat all death. We thank you, God, that we call upon your name tonight, Lord God. Do your work, Lord God, in Brazil. Do what only you can do, Lord God, through your blood. Wash this nation clean. With the blood of the Lamb. We thank you, God, that tonight we leave from this place of intercession with hope in our hearts, knowing, God, that you've already made a way, you've already made a provision, but God, for all sins to be forgiven, for all things to be restored, for everything that needs to change to be changed. We thank you, God, that it's not just wishful thinking tonight, Lord God. We call upon the only name that can save, the only name that can change everything, name that can do the impossible. We thank you, God, that tonight, Lord God, we have hope in our hearts, knowing, God, that you are on the move. Lord God, you know every person. You know them each by name. You know the number of hairs on their heads. You have their names written, Lord God, on the palms of your hands. We rest assured, Lord God, that you are moving on their behalf. We thank you, God. We love you. We pray all these things in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Yeah, thank you guys for joining us today. It was wonderful to just pray for Brazil. I pray that you continue to pray for this nation, especially as the World Cup is still going on, I believe until the second week of July, second or third week of July. And very quickly, next week, we will actually not be having K1. So for the next couple of weeks, a lot of the K1 staff will be out. So unfortunately, we'll have to close down K1 for a couple of weeks. I'm really sorry. If you are really, really sad, come back tomorrow morning at 9:30 in the morning. So have a wonderful night. Bye, guys. Thank you.